Hi, I'm Brittany Lung, and I would like to welcome you to this episode of Race Face Spotlight. Today, we're headed out east to Charlotte, North Carolina, where we find 20-year-old Ridgefield, Connecticut's Anthony Alfredo. Anthony, how are you doing this evening?
I'm doing great. I appreciate you guys making the time for me today.
Thank you so much for joining us. Anthony, you are currently racing a limited schedule in the NASCAR Gander Outdoor Truck Series. Let's talk a little bit about the Truck Series, including your two top 10 finishes.
Well, the Truck Series has been a big step for me in my career. It's honestly a dream come true to be competing at the national level now, and it's very humbling, but at the same time, it's brought out a different competitor in me. I've been working really hard, and you mentioned those two top 10 finishes, which is a big success at this level, but at the same time, we've put ourselves in position to do a whole lot better than that. Honestly, we were in contention to win the second Texas race, and I just made a mistake on pit road, and there's a couple other races we had shots at top fives, and just pit crew either made a mistake. We've had tire issues, stuff like that. So it's really tough. We've had some bad luck, honestly, been taken out in late race accidents, lap one accidents. It's just been one of those years, but hopefully it'll turn around for us here in our final four races.
Sure. It sounds like you are navigating all of that. But in addition to the racing, you are also attending the University of North Carolina at Charlotte, where you're studying engineering. How are you managing to balance the racing and going to school?
That's a great question. You know, it's been really tough, honestly. I'm going into my third year now. I'm a week into my third year, so it's been a challenge. It's really difficult to balance the two just because they're both full-time things. You know, there's a lot of effort you got to put into both, and I like getting my education. I'm very fortunate to get a college education, so I'm working hard on that, but there's a time and a place for that in my racing career, right? Obviously, I've got to prioritize things and usually get stuff done ahead of time so that I can go to the racetrack on the weekend and go compete and focus on that for the time being. So it's tough. It's a never-ending grind, and you know, I love it, though. I wake up every day and just put 110% in and see where I end up.
Yeah, we can tell that you're definitely committed to both your education and your racing. But you're also an avid gamer and an iRacing racer. I also understand that you have a brand new simulator. Can you tell us how you're using that simulator to hone your racing craft?
Absolutely. So, you know, talking about balancing school and racing takes away a lot of that time from gaming, but I'm definitely a passionate gamer, really into the esports industry as a whole, all mainstream games, and definitely iRacing. I'm actually sitting in my SimSeats racing simulator right now that SimSeats built for me. It's incredible setup, and it's so realistic that it really helps me hone my skills on iRacing, and I stream on Twitch when I play iRacing, which is really cool because then the fans kind of get an inside look at how I race because it's so realistic that I have a camera on my pedals and one on me, and you can see me driving, which add to the perspective for the fans to see and even maybe learn some things. And we just have some fun and compete. And like I said, I stream a lot of other games as well, like mainstream esports games like Call of Duty and CSGO. So it's fun to mess around on, and I just enjoy that industry a lot. So I like sharing that passion with the fans and engaging with them, and it's a lot of fun.
I'm sure that's a really cool experience for your fans and one that they might not get with other racers. Rod tells me that you also get time in Toyota's multi-million dollar simulator. What is that like?
That's incredible. I mean, that is so realistic just because you're sitting in what's basically the center of a race car. Like, you strap in the whole nine yards. It's pretty intense, pretty realistic. So that's a great way to prepare for new racetracks, obviously, and feel kind of the way it feels in the real life car. But the nice thing about my SimSeat simulator is it's not a multi-million dollar rig, and I can hop on it whenever I want because it's just sitting in my living room.
What an honor that you are able to use Toyota's multi-million dollar simulator, though. I understand that you're very active on social media, and that includes Twitch, where fans can watch you live stream iRacing. And you just talked a little bit about that.
Yeah, for sure. So I have a series called Racing with Fans, as you mentioned, and I do that on both iRacing and NASCAR's game, NASCAR Heat. We have a lot of fun doing that. I love engaging with the fans, and it's something I care about a lot, and I pride myself in doing. I know there's not a lot of other racers who do that, and it's just something I enjoy doing, and seeing everyone's reaction and doing the same on iRacing's fun, because I'm getting better at iRacing, but I'm not the best. So these guys love beating up on me in iRacing and racing for wins together. So we just have some fun. Like I said, that's what it's all about, but definitely something I'm going to try to do for a really long time.
Now, in addition to interacting with your fans that way, you also have a vlog called Beyond the Helmet, where fans can see what your life is like outside of racing, and an interactive series with called Racing with Fans. Can you share with us how fans can connect with you in that way and how all of that works?
Yeah, for sure. So it all honestly started with my social media platforms, where anyone, if you want to DM me or hit me up, like, I always respond, or I do my best to. And that's what kind of led to me doing something unique for the fans and everybody who supports me. And the Beyond the Helmet series on YouTube was a big hit. It's been a lot of fun. I haven't uploaded one in a really long time because my schedule's been insane. But I really do enjoy doing that because it allows me to kind of show who I am away from the racetrack and what my my day-to-day life is, which obviously sometimes incorporates racing-related things, but it's more so just about my life and letting people get to know me, you know, Anthony Alfredo, not Anthony Alfredo, the race car driver, because that kind of ties back into that fan-connecting realm, you know, just being able for them to get to know who I really am. And that all started with the gaming side, and then I just wanted to do a personal vlog type thing.
Earlier, you mentioned the game Heat, and it's my understanding that on September 13th, NASCAR Heat 4 is releasing, and you are actually in the game. How exciting is that?
It's super exciting. As we were talking about before, I'm a big gamer, honestly, and I'm passionate about the esports industry, so to actually be in a video game is insane. Like, it's really hard to put into words. It's pretty surreal. I was in last year's game, NASCAR Heat 3, which was really cool. Just a blessing. And now I'm in the next one. So it's fun for the fans to be able to play as me. And once again, now I can continue my Racing with Fans series on NASCAR Heat and either race it myself or race against myself, I guess, if some of the fans want to play as me. But it's been a lot of fun. And like I said, it's really cool. It puts things into perspective for me of how far I've come and where I'm at. It's just really humbling, and I'm really thankful.
I'd like to move outside of racing and talk about your relationship with the Friends of Jacqueline Foundation. Can you share with us your involvement and what this means to you?
The Friends of Jacqueline Foundation means a lot to me because my mission and my goal is to utilize my platform, however far I make it or whatever I do in my life, to do good for others. And working with the Friends of Jacqueline Foundation has allowed me to do that by helping them achieve their mission of helping all these young pediatric cancer patients have a better quality of life. And that all started with our adoption ceremony at the race shop at DGR Crosley with Zach, who's battling leukemia. He just turned 8 years old, so I got him some cool birthday gifts. I'm actually going to his house this coming Saturday to play NASCAR Heat with him, so that'll be a lot of fun. And that was a really humbling experience as well, because it put things into perspective about where I'm at. And the fact that I could even be a role model for someone is really humbling. But it also means a lot to me because I know I can help these people just, you know, live better lives. And they're going through so much that it's a, you know, an honor to be able to help and have an impact on the world. So trying to continue to do that. And it's been really fun to do it with the Friends of Jacqueline Foundation.
That's so great. Now, you also have a history of supporting JDRF, and we know this hits close to home for you. Can you tell us why that's so important?
Yeah, of course. So JDRF I've been working with for a little over 3 years now, and helping raise awareness for type 1 diabetes. I have two cousins that were diagnosed. One was diagnosed at 6, and one was diagnosed about a year or two ago now. And that was, you know, something that I grew up seeing firsthand, especially when I go babysit them and stuff and hang out. So I learned a lot about it, not as much as I thought I knew. I actually ended up meeting my girlfriend at school. We've been dating for over a year and a half now, and she's a type 1 diabetic. So I don't believe in coincidences. I think everything's by the grace of God. And I've learned a lot, you know, even more about it from her because of spending a lot of time together. So it's put things into perspective for me and helped me work with JDRF even closer now, because I just want to help them as well achieve their mission, and hopefully I can utilize my platform for a long time to do that.
You seem like you have a really big heart, Anthony. Would you like to take some time and give a shout out to your sponsors?
Of course. So I've got to give a big thanks to obviously all the supporters and my family and everybody who has been there for me, and my partners who've gotten me to this point: Steelsmith, Seco Building Systems, Oxford Energy Group, Mechanic Shop Nora, JDRF, and the Friends of Jacqueline Foundation, and obviously the race team for all the hard work we're putting in. Hopefully we can get a win before the year's over.
Thank you so much, Anthony, for joining us tonight. Well, there you have it. What an amazing story from one of the rising stars in NASCAR. To learn more about Anthony, check him out at anthonyalfredo.com and follow him on social media. Don't forget, if you want to catch up on any of RaceFace Spotlight shows, you can do so at raceface.tv on demand. Until next time, I'm Brittany Lung. Thanks for watching.